As you probably know, Jim Carter, who plays Mr. Carson, big friend of ours, is a huge servant, you know, to the cause. We're going to be sending 120 athletes to LA, I think, plus coaches to compete. I think 8,000 athletes worldwide. So it's fantastic news that we can raise some money to help Team GB do well over there. I think young Michael Fox, who plays Andy in the new series, I've heard him, he's a singer-songwriter, and he's got great tunes, and he's going to be doing a song tonight, so I've told him to be good, because the pressure's on, so he has to deliver.
And of course, we're so excited about the sixth and final season of Downton. Can you tell us what we can expect, particularly for Thomas, because I think of all the characters, his journey's been one that's been the most complex and meant a lot to a lot of people.
Thomas, again, it's never easy for Thomas, and the same this year. He goes on another huge journey. Finds himself alienated at the Abbey, as usual. And, it's all or nothing with Thomas, and it's going to be a big crescendo, a huge, big, powerful scene, hopefully. And will Thomas survive it or won't he? We'll have to wait and see. But, it's pretty much standard for Thomas. It's never easy for him.
What's it like playing a character like that? Because there's a lot of layers to him.
Yeah, it's nice. It's a challenge. Obviously, sexuality in them times is very interesting to play. Being gay in a time when it was illegal. Always fantastic. And I always, it gives you... People love to hate Thomas, so that's great. It's a great part to play. But it's nice to bring a bit of light and shade and show the emotional side to him from time to time.
And overall, what's the tone of the final season?
I think it's pretty much... more of the same. I can probably guarantee a wedding. There'll be the odd funeral or two or nine. And it's just what the audience who watch it seem to, what they love about Downton. It's pretty much as you were from series gone by. We don't know how it's all going to wrap up yet because we haven't received the final episode. I believe it's inbound tomorrow. Julian Fellowes is here tonight, so I might try and get him for a scoop. We'll have to wait and see. But I hope it all ties up. I don't know how he's going to do it. It's too many characters. But he will find a way. That's why he's got an Oscar. Bless you. Somebody's just sneezed.
Apart from Thomas, I'm curious, is there a particular character on the show whose journey has interested you the most, watching your fellow performers alongside you?
I always love watching Mr. Bates, who's played by Brendan Coyle, because Brendan's a superb dramatic actor, and he always brings an edginess to Bates. The powerful stuff the other year when Anna was raped was fantastic, watching how he dealt with that as the husband, you know. So I always love watching Brendan, and I'll be particularly interested to see where Bates ends up this year. Who knows?
How do you feel about the fact it's all coming to an end, and looking back, what's your fondest, most special memory you think you're going to take away from the whole experience?
Just being in work for 6 years, it's pretty hard to do as an actor. So, you know, the security's been great. There's been highlights, you know, the foreign press tours to New York and LA have been fantastic. Trips to the White House. So it's all been great. But 6 years, we've had a good innings. Let's go out on a high.